Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sharifil anbiya wal mursaleen wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. We are continuing our education in terms of you becoming a certified life coach, which we're giving free life coach training program to be certified, free certification all over the world. Inshallah, we're going to train you. All right. And in the previous video, I have explained to you that to be a life coach, you must have certain competencies and skill, starting with the competency at module one, that is motivational skills. Then you learn coaching skill, which I have given you the growth model, GROWTH, on coaching. Now I'm going to give you the mentoring skills, which have the trust, TRUST, trust model, which is an Islamic mentoring skill. And then inshallah we'll have our counseling format at the last stage. So as you develop in your skills, you will then become to become a certified VIP life coach. You can even at this level one become certified. Now don't worry, but this is continuous lifelong education as I'm giving you to transfer the knowledge that Allah has given to me as a consultant, as a human resource consultant, as a coach, so that you then would be able to mentor and help the ummah, especially the young people in the 21st century. And I've given you some idea, the definition of mentoring, and then what is mentoring, the types of mentoring, including online mentoring, and then what is the systems of mentoring in Islam from our Holy Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and also the Sahabat, the Tabi'in, Tabi'in, and carry on through. That's why we have the Sanad system. The Sanad system in terms of Hadith, the Sanad system in terms of Tasawwuf and so on. It goes back all the way to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to Sayyidina Ali or Sayyidina, all the other Khalifah Rashidun, right, and back to us. There is this continuous chain of transmitters, which is the mentorship that we understand. And also from the Quranic perspective, Islamic perspective, you will understand how Nabi Khidir and Moses, where Nabi Khidir mentor Moses on the ilmu laduni, the ilm that is beyond space and time, which you can understand from the Quran. Alright, so today I'm going to give you an Islamic mentoring model, which I call TRUST, T-R-U-S-T. Yeah? So this is an acronym. Again, it's easy to remember, because once you remember, oh, this is an Islamic mentoring model, it's called TRUST, T-R-U-S-T. And each, every one of this letter represents something. All right. So then I'll explain to you what is T. For example, T equals trust. That's the first thing. That's why we call this the trust model, because there must be fullness of trust between the mentor and the mentee. Because if the mentee do not trust the mentor, they cannot build a relationship. There's no way that you can build a relationship. How to build trust? I will give you a few tips, a few pointers in which then you can develop trust. But trust is something that is beyond us, because where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alamin, except to become the rahmah, the amanah, the trust. So we are also as a trust by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be his khalifah on this earth. There are many issues of trust, but then this is how we go down to micro level in terms of trust to our mentee, between mentor and mentee. This is more at that level. R is rapport. You cannot mentor a person if you do not have rapport. So how to build rapport? What are the parameters of rapport? How to go about in terms of your five senses, in terms of your mental state, in terms of your akal, your qalb, your heart, and so on. So that is where we build rapport. You is unique, because you must understand that each and every one relationship between a mentor and mentee is unique. No, there's no one single template. So that's why you must have a knowledge of human sciences or human psychology or human sociology, which is based on life experience, as well as you got to study some of the great masters in Islam, of how this relationship is built up. Because your relationship between you and your mentee is very unique. It is one to one, or even in the group also have their own perspective and uniqueness, and how you can navigate this whole idea of having a very unique rapport and trust relationship, trusting relationship. S is for synchronicity. Synchronicity is where we have this holistic preview of the purpose and the meaning of life, which you got to infuse in mentoring, because we are not a circular mentoring school. We are Islamic. So Islamic talks about the holistic nature of our human self in terms of our spiritual, emotional, mental and physical, in terms of our roh, our qalb, our akal, our jasad, and how they are integrated, which I have explained to you in many videos before that, and how you can infuse this idea of synchronicity, because modern human beings that are having a lot of psychological and sociological problems, they are basically monodimensional. They are not synchronous. They are either addicted to certain things and certain behavior because their personality is split. They do not have an integrated synchronous and they do not have a synchronous identity in terms of their understanding in life. So synchronicity is allowing you to have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to have tawakkul, to have so many things. When you have that as your value system, inshallah, then you will heal yourself from your problems and challenges that you face in life. Alright, then, so you have T-R-U-S, and then T, the last T is time-bound. Because as you provide a mentor-mentee relationship, it is bounded by time, maybe even a lifetime. You may have a young man who is your mentee, and he's attached to you, and you gave him a lot of help, and then he is successful in his career. And he is also successful, for example, in his marriage life. And he's also so he becomes part of your family. So there are many situations where I can see this beautiful relationship. Because, for example, like in Malaysia, we have this adopted child. For example, somebody who is even an adult is adopted by another family, just like they are their son or their daughters. And then every time when we have this Eid, we'll go, we bring our children and go to that person who is our adopted father or adopted mother. And it's like a family. We have a good time together because that man or woman who is our mentor, who is our adopted father in that sense, has given so much for us. And we have this full love as if he or she is our father. At that level, then we have succeeded as a mentor in terms of helping, especially as I say, the young people now who are monodimensional, who are psychologically very fragile, who are socially introvert and or extreme extrovert, who are having a lot of problems in terms of seeking meaning and purpose in life, who have no vision and no mission beyond just having some fun, all right, or having some drugs or having some sex or whatever that is bounded by them because of this dunya. This is the lowest plane of our existence, and we have to help our children, our great-grandchildren, as we navigate the 21st and 22nd century. We must bring this whole idea of mentoring them, helping them, bringing all the sciences of psychology, sociology, Islamic metaphysics, tenets of Islam, and all the other integrated fields of knowledge in which we can then bring about to have a very successful approach to help our ummah and along the way help humanity to live in peace, happiness and success, having wonderful relationship between Muslims and non-Muslims, all this understanding that we have, this deen is filled with Rahman and Rahim, the mercy and compassion of Allah, always with the Ghafurul Wadud, the forgiveness and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that transcends all of us, our brothers and sisters in Islam, all of humanity, all the goodly creatures on this earth, and even this universe, which Allah is the absolute creator who give us this sense of purpose and meaning. And hopefully, in one small measure, you can help yourself, your family, your community by becoming our certified life coach, which is very easy. Go to our website, islamicpsychology.net, and then you can find all the details, or contact us, and then we can communicate through WhatsApp to give you how you can go about helping yourself, your family, helping your community, and helping the world to make this world a better world as a Khalifa of Allah, as His vice servant and Khalifa of Allah. Always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, making the world good, inshallah.